Okay. Now I'm going to delete the features I just made and start from the top and cover revolved bus. Again, define a plane, spacebar, normal tool. Now I'm going to make a sketch. This time another rectangle. Maybe half a circle above it. Like this. Now I'm going to trim the extra parts of my circle, which I don't need, and add a line over here because I need it up to here. By clicking on trim, you have four options. I just suggest you to use either with power trim, which you just click on anywhere you want and hold the button down, the left key, and drag your mouse around, and it cuts anywhere you just cover, as you can see. Or just work with this, which cuts any part which is stuck between two other points or lines, like this, that, and that. Very easy. Okay, I have my part. It's underdefined. It's not necessary to have it fully defined. I'm just going to show you, but I'm going to the features, click on revolved bus, and it needs an axis for the reference of revolution. I'm just going to choose this one. There you go. 360 degrees. There you go. That's the basic of revolved bus. You can have other options as well. Just work with it. It's really easy. Oh, by the way I'm editing this is just left click on it. Wait. There's a pop-up screen really small over here. This is edit feature. This is edit sketch of that feature you're watching or you're seeing over here. That suppresses the feature. Not really necessary for the beginners, but let me know if you want me to cover that as well. Normal to hide, it's really easy, just very user friendly. Okay, another sketch, another plane. Okay. True blind 50 millimeters. It's okay. Okay, now that I have a block, I can see my other feature is enabled. Mirror, shell. Okay, let me start from extruded bus, which is the next necessary feature you need. I'm gonna extrude, cut a circle through that block. Okay, either I need a plane and have a draw a circle on it, or I just can draw a circle on this plane because it really can be a plane. It can work as a plane for you. Just left click on this side or any side you want. You see sketch, not edit sketch, sketch. Okay, space, normal to circle. There you go. Oh, by the way, this is important, but I get to that later. A feature tab, extruded cut. You see? Line, through all, offset from surface, 10 mil. There you go. Very easy. That was extruded cut. Now let go with the hold wizard. It's a little bit more advanced. Revolve cut does the same thing as extruded cut does for extruded bus, but for revolved bus. I'm not sure my sentence was absolutely right, but it's just revolved bus, but it just cuts the part out. I'm not sure if I've been clear, but you get it, right? Let's go with the swept bus for now, not loft. Fillet. Fillet, manual fillet, it's really easy, just need to highlight the edges or the planes surfaces 2 and define the radius, obviously, to curve your edges. Okay, if you click on this arrow underneath the fillet, you see chamfer, which does this, cuts the part. Oh, it's not gonna work this, oh, because of this fillet, right? Okay, here, that's chamfer. Mirror just doubles or mirrors your part. Like this. Shell, let me get to that, it's important. No chamfer, no fillet, and no extruded cut. Okay, simple block. Shell, just choose the plane or surface you want to have it cut out, and don't choose the others you want to have it, have them not cut out. Five, click. There you go. It the width of each one of these walls are 5 millimeters. If I go to evaluate tab, I click on measure, and click on this surface and also this one, it gives me the distance, which is 5. Why? Because I just defined it over here, 5. If I edit this and choose this surface as well, what it does, just cuts it. There you go.